Day 69, a relatively nice day, but with some paranormal activity. We headed over to the guiding lands to investigate what we were told was a ghost. We didn't really believe it though, so we headed over to the Coral Highlands for an initial check. Coral Puke Puke, some tracks from the monster, and a silver Rathalos? Nothing out of the ordinary. So we decided to use a banishing ball to send the Rathalos home because we're nice, and then we summoned the Tsidziyaku, the monster known for the paranormal activity. To make sure we weren't seeing things, we decided to head up to the coral region before it appeared so that we can see things unfold with our very eyes. As we got up, we saw some spots here for Tsidziyaku even though it hadn't arrived yet. And as we headed up the hill, we started feeling more and more the presence of the monster before it arrives. We could see on the mini-map that it will arrive up above on the bridge, but nothing down here. At least we thought. What is that? Is there another CZ here that we just can't see? Another track. What's going on here, is it? If the monster's here, then what was behind us? And what's here? And what's here? What the heck are all these tracks? There is some paranormal activity going on in the coral region of the Guiding Lands, and we, the Guild, need to take care of it at all costs.
That's right, join the Paranormal Activity Tracking Unit. This is a method for getting your coral region from level 1 to level 7 in 70 minutes or less. Not as fast as the Wildspire region, but this one is in much more demand because this is the area that pays out the materials that you need for health augmenting your weapons. Each tracking mission takes roughly 5 minutes, and in every 3 runs or so, you're going to gain a level. And the process is super easy. So when you do this method, all you really need to do is have an armor skill, stealth level 3, and intimidator level 3, which you can easily get. This is just to make sure that the large monster and the small monsters, they don't notice you, they don't react to you, so you can just walk around stalking the monster and collecting its tracks. When you first lure it out, don't wait for it here. Go up the mount and start collecting all those ghost tracks because it gives a nice little bonus. I don't know if this is a bug, if they're going to fix it, but even without these ghost tracks, this method is still very effective. But while they're there, you may as well grab them, right? So go ahead and grab all these ghost tracks. Meanwhile, the Tsidziyaku is going to appear down below. In fact, these tracks stick around for quite some while, so don't feel rushed to go down the slope and collect all the other ones. You have plenty of time to go around up here and make sure that you get everything before you move on. I'm going to show you all the major points here in this video, but there may be some additional ones. You never know, because this monster leaves so many tracks. It's ridiculous. Actually, as you get the level higher, you might even get lucky and have a Kirin in the area at the same time at Tsidziyaku, and at that point it is going to be a festival of tracks for you to collect. But for the most part, just concentrate on Tsidzi, and that is going to be the best way to level up to number 7 without any shenanigans. So ignore all the other monsters, just focus on Tsidzi, because that's the one that will raise the coral region, and just collect tracks. It's great. If you don't want to use Intimidator or Stealth, you will have to use a Ghillie Mantle just to make sure that nothing sort of notices you. But honestly, just get the skills. It's simple. You don't need anything else on your armor, so not a big deal. Make sure that you're not directly behind the monster because there are 3 different points in which it will do a back kick and leave those gashes on the ground. So you don't want to make sure that you don't get hit because it will mess up its pattern. So once it goes downstairs, checks out the forest and comes back up the hill over here, it will start heading up the mound. We're going to go ahead and collect all of its tracks as it goes up the mound. These are in pretty much the same location as those ghost tracks, but they're going to appear again because the monster is making them. And then it's going to run down and jump towards the lake, in which case we'll just trap it just once for some extra points, then use a banishing ball to send it packing home. You don't want to continue your tracking mission beyond this point because once it goes downstairs, it'll take a nap, it won't leave any tracks, then it'll run upstairs, eat, there won't be any tracks, then it'll come down, drink water, rest some more. It's really ineffective. So at this point, just use a shock trap. Use 2 if you can, as it's just some extra points. It'll make this go faster. Then use a banishing ball to send it packing. Go back and lure another one and just rinse and repeat. Like the Baroth method, about every 3 times you do this, you're going to go up a level, perhaps even faster if you're using traps just to get those extra points. And really, in no time, you're going to be max level. And again, if you're using a rarity 12 weapon and you want to get the health augments, you will need materials from the Tempered Namiel, which only appears in this area when it's level 7. So it's a very worthwhile area to level up, and I highly recommend it. Hope you guys enjoyed this quick tip, and until next time, happy trackin'.